In this video, I explain the MCQ of coupling, clutch and brake. First MCQ is, a power transmission element are used for transmitting power from one shaft to another shaft is known as option A clutch, option B coupling, option C brake and option D both A and B. So here we know that the clutch is used to engage and disengage the two shaft. Okay, so it is also used for the power transmissions. Coupling is also used for the power transmission from one shaft to another shaft. Brake is used for stop the vehicles or reduce the speed of the vehicles. Okay, so here the option A and B both are correct, means option D is the correct answer, both A and B. Which of the following element is used to connect the two shaft? Option A clutch, option B brake, option C coupling. So answer is the coupling. Okay, so here question is asked to connect the two shaft. Okay, so when we connect the two shaft, it make the couple. Okay, that is the two shaft are joint and then make the couple, that's why it is called as the coupling. So couple means that is a two thing. So same way here the two shaft is there, then it is called as the coupling. Which of the following element is used to engage or disengage of driving shaft and driven shaft whenever required? Option A clutch, option B brake and option C coupling. So we know that the clutch is used to engage and disengage of the driving and the driven shaft. So option A is the correct. So earlier during the MCQ 1 I explained the functions of all these three components. Okay, so just we know the function, then we are able to give the answer of number of question. Which of the following type of coupling do not allow any relative relations between the two shaft? Oldham coupling, universal coupling, rigid coupling and the flexible coupling. Okay, so rigid coupling is not allowed the any relative motions between the two shaft. So here option C is the correct. A coupling is used to protect the driving and driven machines against harmful effect produced due to small misalignment of shaft as a vibration, sudden shock loads or a shaft expansion. Option A universal coupling, option B boost pin type flange coupling, option C Oldham coupling, option D all of the above. So here the all of the above answer is the correct. So here the correct answer is option D. Which of the following coupling is used to connect two parallel shaft which do not alignment and their axes are small distance apart? Means the two shaft are in a same axis but there is a some offset between the two shaft. Okay, so at that time we are using the Oldham coupling. So here the number of option is given, but correct answer is the Oldham coupling, that is the option D is the correct answer. Before moving on the another MCQ, I request to like the video and subscribe my channels for watching the more video related to the BME as well as other subject of the mechanical engineering. For the BME, various link is provided in descriptions as well as the in a card. For other subject, I request to visit the playlist. Coupling is used to connect the two shaft whose axes are intersect. Option A universal coupling, B Oldham coupling, C boost pin flange coupling and option D clamp coupling. So here option A is the correct answer. The universal coupling is used when the two shaft axes are intersect, means one shaft is the at certain angles with the another shaft, at that time we need to use the universal coupling. Which of the following clutch is not friction clutch? Disc clutch, coin clutch, teeth head clutch and the centrifugal clutch. So here option C is the correct answer. The teeth head clutch is not a friction clutch. In an automobile, which of the mechanical clutch is used to connect the engine to the driven shaft? Means in a various vehicle, which type of the clutch is used? Option A jaw clutch, option B teeth head clutch, option C disc clutch. So here the option C is the correct answer. The answer is the disc clutch. In automobile, which of the following coupling is used to connect the engine shaft to a driven shaft? That is a MUF coupling, boost pin type flange couplings, Oldham couplings and the universal couplings. So your correct answer is the D, universal coupling is used to connect the engine shaft to the driven shaft. Okay, so here coupling is asked. In earlier questions the ask about the clutch. Okay, so in a automobile the disc clutch is used and as a coupling the universal coupling is used. A clutch is require less axial pressure to disengage the clutch. Means in a which type of the clutch the less axial pressure is required? Option A, single disc clutch. Option B, multi disc clutch. Option C, corn clutch. So here the correct answer is the option C, corn clutch. A clutch is used for the transmission of power in agriculture equipments like tractor, threshers. Okay, option A is centrifugal clutch. Option B, jaw clutch. Option C, multi disc clutch. And corn clutch. So here correct answer is the multi disc clutch. So here these tractors and threshers are the heavy vehicles. Okay, so in heavy vehicles we need to use the multi disc, means that are required more frictions. Filling the blank is used to transmit the power from driving shaft to driven shaft, which may be required to start or stop frequently. Option A, brake. Option B, coupling. Option C, clutch. So here the answer is the clutch, that is option C is the correct answer. In a centrifugal clutch, the shoe move radially outward with the help of hand operated levers due to centrifugal force. Option C is spring force and none of the above. So here the answer B is the correct, that is a centrifugal force. That's why it is called as the centrifugal clutch. Means the jaw are move inwards or outwards due to the centrifugal force. That's why it is called as the centrifugal clutch. In order to slow down or stop the motion of a machine, following device is used. So in a first MCQ we already discussed, the brake is used to stop the motion of a vehicles or a machines or reduce the speed. Okay, so various option is given, that is a clutch, coupling and brake. So we know that the brake is the correct answer. The energy absorbed by the brake is released in a surrounding in a form of, means when we apply the brake liner is, temperature is increased, means the energy is released in the form of heat energy. So here option is given, kinetic energy, pressure energy, heat energy and the potential energy. So we know that the correct answer is the heat energy. In a centrifugal clutch, the force with shoe pressure against the driven member is the difference of centrifugal force and the spring force, sum of the centrifugal force, only spring force and only centrifugal force. Here correct answer is the option A, means difference of centrifugal force and the spring force is equal to force with shoe pressure against the driven member. A brake commonly used in a railway train is shoe brake, band brake, internal expansion brakes. So correct answer is the shoe brake, and these shoe brakes are operated by using the pneumatic system. So in a railway trains the shoe brake is used. A brake commonly used in motor car, option A shoe brake, option B band brake and option C internal expansion brake. So here correct answer is the internal expansion brake. Earlier we study about the railway, so in a railway line the shoe brake is used, and in a motor car the internal expansion brake is used. A brake commonly used in civil construction equipment is shoe brake, clutches, gear drives. So here the option B is the correct, the clutch is used as a brake in a civil construction's equipment. Plate type, cone type and centrifugal type are a type of which device? Coupling, brake, clutch and gear drives. So correct answer is the option C. So we know that the clutch have a various type, the plate type clutch, cone type clutch and the centrifugal type clutch. A hydraulic coupling belong to the category of power absorbing machine, power developing machine, energy transfer machines and energy generating machine. So we know that the hydraulic coupling is used to transmitting the power, means it is called as the energy transfer machine. So option C is the correct answer. So thank you for watching this video. If you learn something, then like the video, subscribe my channels and share with your friends.